Hello and welcome back to Excelsif. How many times you've come across a large data set and needed to find something and you had to resort to use the Control F option or use the filters just so you can search? Shouldn't there be something simple like the search box in search engines? That's what we are going to create today. A search box in Excel which works as you want it to, exact matches, partial matches, and even if you wanted to search everywhere in your data set. This is our data for today. We have first and last name, city, country, age, and sales. You can download this sheet for free in the description so you can use it with your data too. Let's begin. First off, let's convert this data into a table. So click anywhere within this data and press Ctrl T. Make sure all your data is selected and this option here is checked. Press OK. Just make a note of the table name from here. That will be useful in a bit. For instance, in this sheet, this table is named Table 1. Now moving to the search box bit. We can make a search box here, but I would like to keep it professional and tidy. So we are going to make a search box in another sheet. But we are going to need the headers from here, so let's copy them and paste them in this new sheet. Let's create a box quickly where we can input our search term. So let's go to the Insert tab. Shapes, and let's select the rounded rectangle. Now we'll draw it till here. Let's change the color a bit. This one is too much for me. Let's go to shape styles and let's choose this one. It also has a nice shadow effect. What search box is complete without the magnifying glass? So let's add that too. Go back to the insert tab, icons. And by the way, you can put an image here as well as per your choice. Instead of going with icons, go to image option in the insert tab. In here, let's type search and let's choose this one. Click on insert and here we have our magnifying glass. Let's put it here by dragging it and resize it so it fits in our rectangle. And for your last trick, let's change the color of this magnifying glass as well. Go to Graphics Format tab up here. While you have this icon selected and under Graphics Fill, select the white color. That's better. As of now, this only looks like a search box. But we know that this is just a rectangle and we can't type anything here, let alone do anything regarding search. So let's start working towards that. We are going to need the Developer tab up here. If you don't have it, right-click anywhere on this ribbon and go to Customize ribbon. And down here, you will find the Developer option. Put a check mark here and hit OK. In our Developer tab, we need to go to the Insert tab and choose this option. Text box under ActiveX controls. Let's drag this text box to the full length of our search box like this. Right-click on this newly created text box and go to Properties. And we are going to this option, Linked Cell. Click here and type F5. This is so we can assign a cell to the search box. Now, whatever we type here, Excel will replicate this in cell F5. That means we can use cell F5 in our formulas. Next up, go down to Special Effects here and choose the first option from this dropdown and close this Properties box. You still won't be able to type anything here because when you click here, it selects the text box. To fix that, get out of the design mode from the developers tab. Now this text box is working. That's the beautification bit done. Now let's get to the job at hand. For the first part, we are going to make a search box which works with an exact match. We are going to use the filter function for this and further scenarios for partial data match and universal too. If you want to know more about the filter function, I have used this function in my videos about VStack and Take and some more. I'll leave the links in the description for you to watch. Let's write our formula here in F9. We start with filter. For array, we can mention table 1. For include, we need to match this value in F5 to the first name. So let's select our first name column. Make sure you don't include the header in your selection. Start from the first record and then press Ctrl Shift down arrow to select till the end. And then is equal to F5. This makes sure that only those records are fetched which are mentioned in the search box. For if empty argument, we mention no records found in double quotes. And that completes our formula for this part. Let's test it. Let's copy this first name and paste it here. And it works fine. Let's try another one. Let's copy the first one and paste it in our search box. And it works on multiple cases too. But bear in mind that this is only working for the first name. If you want your data to focus on the last name, just get in here in the formula and change this bit to last name. Now, if we select this and paste in our search box, we get our data from last names only. This will work for many of us, but it only works with exact matches. Meaning, if I am to delete even a character from a search string like this, it will say no record found. Let's fix that so it works on partial matches as well. To include partial matches, we are going to use the same filter formula, but with a small change. We are going to incorporate two more formulas, search and isNumber. Let me give you a quick idea what they do. The search function searches for text, which can be a single character or a word in a given cell, and if found, returns with the position of the character or the word. Let me explain on our data sheet here. Let's say our search string is li. Let's write that here. Now, if we use the search function for find text, we are going to refer to this cell here, which we need to find. And for within text, we are going to select the whole first name column. Close brackets, and here we have our results. Wherever it has a number, it means our search string is present at that position in that cell. Like it says 3 in the first result, and in our cell, it is indeed present at the third position. Down here, it says 1, and it is present at the very beginning. The second formula is the simplest. If it finds a number in a cell, it returns true. Otherwise, it returns false. And this one is known as the isNumber function. Let's use that here. Copy and paste it down, and wherever it found a number, it returns true. Otherwise, it returns false. We are going to use these formulae together in our filter function to replace our include argument. So let's delete these search and isNumber results from here and get back to our search box sheet. In our filter formula, all we have to do is to replace our include argument with this one. So select the include argument, delete it, and start with isNumber, then search. For find text, we mention a search string which is in F5, and we need it found in table 1 first name column. So let's select that and close brackets for search, and then for isNumber, and that's all. As you can see, it works flawlessly with partial matches in the name as well. But again, it works only in first name. For instance, if I am looking for this last name, it says no record found. Because even if it can search for partial matches, it still is looking in the first name column only. Let's fix this. Now to give superpowers to our search bar, let's make some simple copy and paste modifications in our formula to include all the columns. As of now, if we need to find all the employees of a certain age, say 35, it will say no records found. So, in our include argument, we have our formula looking in the first name column only. All we have to do is to modify it so it can check in all the columns. Do that, we copy the include argument from our formula, which is this isNumber bit. Put a plus symbol right after this and paste it back. Now just go and change this first name to last name. And you don't even have to go back to that data sheet again. Simply type last year and you'll be able to select it like this. So now you know for the remaining fields, we have to repeat the same trick. So let's do that quickly. While I am doing this in the fast forward mode, let me give you a quick idea of how this will work. Once we have added all these fields in our formula, it will search in all the fields instead of just one, because the plus symbol will act as the OR function. So, if it can't find it in the first column, it will move on to the next one, and then to the next one, and so on and so forth. That's done, and here we have our values. Now, our search box is complete. Whatever you want to throw at it, it will handle it beautifully. But as you might know, I always strive for perfection. So I think we can still tweak this a bit here and there to get a better version out of it. For starters, currently whatever we are searching for, it shows the results, no problem. But we have to check where has it got the result from. For example, if I am to search for OS, it gives me all these results. Now I have to find which cell has OS in it that prompted this result. If only that particular cell containing the search string could be highlighted. Well, it can be. We just have to use conditional formatting for this. Let's select our current result and a bit more so our conditional formatting covers more results as well. Now let's go to conditional formatting, highlight cell rules, text that contains. In here, select our cell F5. And in this drop-down, let's choose this option, yellow fill with dark yellow text. And here we have all the cells containing our search string highlighted. Neat, right? Let's do one more. Last one, I promise. As you can see, our current results don't have any borders. And since our results are dynamic, we can't simply apply borders to all the cells. Instead, we're going to select all the results and some more cells like the last time. Go to conditional formatting, new rule. Format only cells that contain, and in this dropdown, select no blanks. Go to format, border, and outline. Hit OK and now whatever results we have, they will have nice borders all the way. Not to mention the highlight we implemented in our last trick. That's your search box completed. You'll find the sheet's link in the description. You can use it for practice or maybe with your own data. I hope you liked this video. I take great care to simplify complex issues and formulae to bring you videos like this. And any share, comment, like, and subscription are much appreciated. I'll see you in the next one. Until then, happy spreadsheeting.